Will thou compass him as with a shield? Favor gonna be all around me. Favor gonna protect me. It's gonna be like a shield. So when my enemies go to hating on me, they're gonna see this favor on me, they're gonna have to back off. Mark chapter 11. New Testament, Mark chapter 11. Look what it says. And when ye stand praying, first thing you got to do is forgive. You have a problem with anybody, or all against any, that your Father also which is in heaven may forgive you your trespasses. 26. Y'all make sure y'all keep that mic handy because this mic look like it's acting crazy already.
Yeah,
I need my backup mic. Now, this morning, I want to talk about 10 things that will cause favor not to operate in your life.
All right.
Because y'all do know the past 2 weeks, Pastor been preaching and teaching, Lord, give me favor. Am I right about it? But this morning I want to talk about 10 things that will cause favor not to operate in your life. And I know nobody in here, in Corrine this morning, it is perfect in here, but I need to tell you this morning, if you want favor to operate in your life, you have to live right. And not only live right, but you have to treat other people right. Y'all ain't talking to me up in here. See, the problem with some of us is when we want to look at how other people are living, but see when favor is upon you, you really don't have time to be looking at nobody else. Can I get a witness up in here? That's because I got favor on my life, and favor tells me if I just can get myself together first. Y'all ain't talking to me up in here. Tell somebody, I got so much favor on my life, I'm not even thinking about what you're doing when you leave church. I got enough trying to keep John Bailey together. Y'all ain't shouting with me up in here because one thing I know is if I just can make sure I'm right with God, he promised me in Psalm number 84, verse 11. Matter of fact, I like this verse so much, Brother Major, I want everybody to look at it. I want you to see Psalm 84 and 11. Turn there, Psalm 84 and 11. Look what Psalm 84 and 11 says. For the Lord God is a sun and shield. The Lord will give grace. The Lord, in other words, the Lord will give favor and glory. Look what else it says. He says, no good thing will he withhold.
Sabbath.
Will he withhold from them that what?
Walk
uprightly. Y'all don't hear me up here this morning. In other words, if I walk right, God is going to give me favor, y'all. Somebody scream favor. God is going to give me favor. Tell somebody, don't hate on my favor. Just check my walk out. Y'all don't hear me up in here. A lot of times folks hate on you because you walking in favor. Baby, don't hate on me. Don't even get mad with me. Don't you stop speaking to me because favor is on me, baby. It may be because I'm walking in the favor. Y'all don't hear me up in here. Give somebody a high five and say, I'm walking in favor. I'm walking in favor. Now quickly, before I taxi on out of here, quickly, let me give y'all 10 things that will cause you to lose your favor, not operate in favor. You better write these down. Number one, always complaining will cause you not to operate in favor. Y'all don't hear me up in here. Because if you spend most of your time complaining, that means you're not spending time giving God praise. You're not spending enough time giving God thanks. You're always complaining. Some of y'all complain as soon as you come up in church. It's too cold up in here. It's too hot. If your rep preach too long, rep preach too short. You're always complaining about everything. The choir you sing too long. Stop complaining! Some people, they just complain about everything. If you don't watch out after you get off the telephone with them, they will have you complaining. Do I have a witness up in here? Anybody ever was feeling good and somebody called you on the telephone and they went to talking about their neck hurting, their hand hurting, their back hurting, their knee hurting, their toe hurting, their finger hurting? As soon as you got off the phone, you went to talking about your hand hurting, your neck hurting, your back hurting, your toe hurting, or everything hurting. Y'all don't hear me up in here. Somebody say amen. The second thing that will cause you not to operate in the favor of God is having a gossiping spirit. Y'all ain't saying nothing over here. Yeah. Having a gossiping spirit will cause you not to operate in favor. And see, there are some people, y'all, they just love stirring up mess. There comes a time in your life, sisters and brother, when you need to grow up. There comes a time in your life where when people call you a mess, you got to tell them, I'm too blessed to be in mess. Y'all ain't shouting with me over here. Tell somebody, give somebody a high five and say, neighbor, I'm too blessed to be in mess. My senior don't want me. Matter of fact, don't even call me no more. Y'all don't hear me up in here. I'm too blessed to be in mess. And see, people who call you with all that kind of mess, you won't know how to get them off the phone quick, fast, in a hurry. Go to quote some scriptures. Y'all don't hear me up in here. Yeah, go to quote some scriptures, home. I guarantee you, they get off the phone. Go to tell them the Lord is my light and my salvation. Who shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Or whom shall I be afraid? Go to tell them Psalm 23, the Lord is my shepherd and I shall not want. Go to tell them Psalm 34, 8. All taste and see that the Lord is good. If you keep quoting scriptures, you won't get the devil off the phone. Tap somebody and say, don't you call me with all that mess. The third thing, I'm on number three. That will cause you not to operate. Anybody want favor on their life? Well, I'm glad you're here this morning. The third thing that will cause favor not to operate in your life is not being on time for work and you're always late. I'm stepping on somebody's toes. That will cause favor not to promote you. You'll have a witness. See, because when raise time come, you can't get favor because you do know your supervisor keep a file on you. You do know that. And some of y'all I watch every Sunday, you come up in church late. You come late and you leave early. God is a God of order. And if you want to walk in favor, you got to do things decently. The fourth thing that will cause favor not to operate in your life. I'm going to see if I can get some noise up in here. The fourth thing that will cause favor not to operate in your life. Not paying your tithes and your offerings. will cause favor not to work or operate in your life. I've seen it with my own two eyes. When you give God, God will send somebody in your life to be a blessing to your life. Y'all don't hear me up in here. Anybody know God will use people sometimes to bless you? That's why you can't have me look out of your ways. Because you don't know who God is going to send your way to be a blessing in your life. Y'all ain't shouting with me up in here. Can I back up what I'm talking about? How God will use people to be a blessing to your life. Look at Luke chapter 6, verse 38. I'm almost finished. Luke 6:38. Somebody said, "Teach, Pastor." I need Luke. See that. Look what happens. See when you give. Look what happens when you give. It says, "Give, and it shall be given unto you." Good measure. Pressed down. Shaking together. Tell somebody. Tap somebody. Tell them. Get ready for the overflow to come in your life. Get ready for favor to overflow, because when it comes, it's going to be running over. Matter of fact, it's going to run over so much you're going to have to call your next door neighbor who ain't been speaking to you for the past 5 years, and you're going to have to bless them with some pork chop. You're going to have to bless them with some red beans. You're going to have to help them with their water bill. You're going to have to help them with, y'all don't hear me up in here. If you hear me up in here. I'm not finished with that verse. I need Luke 6:38. Look what it said. Run over. That goes, shall men give? See how God will use somebody else to be a blessing? Shall men give unto your bosom? Let me give you number five. Everybody say number five. I'm talking about things that will cause favor not to operate in your life. Having an ungrateful spirit will cause favor not to operate in your life. Can I preach up in here this morning? See, sometimes you do things for people and they don't even tell you thank you. Y'all gonna get up in here. You do things for your children. Y'all gonna say amen now. Sometimes you do things for your children. You sacrifice to go without so they can have, and they don't even appreciate